direction concerned with the syllabus. Especially, first we will think about the English subject, means English core, English elective. Other also courses are there, but we have chosen English core and this syllabus. It is a very interactive syllabus. I hope that you have purchased textbooks. In that, two textbooks. One is Hornbill and one is Snapshot. And as per my previous video, I already told you that to read minimum two chapters from Hornbill, two, and from Snapshot, two chapters. So you might have done that. But before discussing the textbooks, it is very important to discuss the question paper design. So you will have the clear picture, and some students, they are from state board, they will also understand that how paper will be there, how is the design of the course, and you will get the confidence. So for getting that confidence, today in this first session, I will discuss question paper design. Paper pattern is easy. Understanding of the each and every section will help you to plan your study, and you will do that task according to your own abilities. Don't think that you are not able to communicate. Don't think that you are new, because I will tell you one example. 12th class, first batch, one student from Marathi medium. That student also stood first in English. That time that student's score was 95, Saroj Tiwari. So such type of things, when you are planning with proper guidance, then it is not the thing that you will do something. And only one mark student is not able to achieve, means our topper is, last year topper is 99 marks, Soloni Joshi. And you have that opportunity and challenge to compete and change that target and achieve the 100 marks target. So think in positive way. All the tasks, whichever it is mentioned in the book and in the course, all the tasks are easy. Think in a proper way to attempt that, and when we will have special interaction in classroom, you will again enjoy that task. So first we will start discussion of the question paper design. In that, three sections, especially three sections are there. Section number 1 in section A. Section A, 20 marks. In that, reading comprehension. So reading comprehension, everybody knows that unseen passages. So here, unseen passages, in that how will be the structure of the passage, that all the details, whatever it is mentioned in the CBSE, that I will refer for you. So reading comprehension, There shall be two unseen passages, including poems, with a variety of questions like objective questions, short answer questions, and multiple choice questions, including 4 marks for vocabulary, such as word formation and inferring meaning. So here, what is important? Multiple choice questions, 6 marks. Here MCQ, one into six marks, and then objective type questions. Yes, that is also very short answer, objective type questions for 6 marks. Objective type questions. Now here 6, this 6, 12, and remaining further I will refer. Here the range of the 2 passages, including a poem or a stanza, should be 900 to 1000 words as per the following details. So here word limit of the passage is given, or the poem it is given. First, the passage of 550 to 600 words in length will be used for note making and summarizing. So these 2 study skills, we will first discuss that, summarizing and note making in detail, when we will discuss writing skill especially. In that, this is a study skill, but they are asking in the section A. Means they will provide you one unseen passage, and you have to read that unseen passage, and then you have to make the notes of that. And how to make that notes, detailed discussion afterwards we will take. Then that same passage, we have to summarize the passage in very short synopsis, means 1/3 synopsis of that passage, summary of that passage we have to write. So here they have given note making 4 marks and summarizing 4 marks. So here note making 4 marks and summarizing 4 marks. So total here 6 and this total 8 marks. So total 20 marks this structure is there. So think in this manner. Now section B. Section B is of 30 marks. And in this, especially what it will include? Writing skill and grammar. So both the things are here included, writing skill and grammar. So here I will refer for you. In writing skill, what will be asked? One short answer question based on notice, poster, advertisement. Posters and advertisement should lead to creative rendering, provisions for which should be made in the marking scheme. So here short answer question, and it will be for 4 marks. So in writing skill, short answer based question, it will be based on which type of writing skills? In that they have mentioned notice writing. Then designing the poster, then drafting advertisement, all that skills are important for the commercial also point of view. So this course is integrated course, and advanced writing skills also here we have to practice. In that commercial advertisements, all that things in different lecture, one lecture we will discuss each topic in proper way. So here this first question, one short answer question will be for 4 marks. Then 2 long answer questions. 2 long answer questions. Letters based on verbal / visual input. So 6 mark 2 questions means 12 marks. So it would cover all types of letters. Letter types may include. So what type of letters will be asked? So in this first one, business or official letters. So in that business or official letters, what will include for making inquiries, registering complaints, asking for or giving information, placing orders, and sending replies. So this thing will include. We will learn all that types of letters in detail afterwards. Then next, letters to the editor. They are giving suggestions, opinions on the issue. Here, provide realistic context in a form of newspaper report, article to which the students may respond. Here, letters to editor, you might have practiced in 10th. Here in detail means level is changing. So as per the level, if you are observing that task, and when you will give you 100%, surely your task will be better. Then application for a job with a bio data or resume. This is also important in everyone's life, that when we are applying for any job, how to write that application letter, how to follow the code of the conduct, and how to plan properly. So everything with proper bio data, resume, all the information is from name to experience, reference, then qualification, all the details we have to give, and that we will learn. Then letter to the school or college authorities regarding admission, school issues, requirement, suitability of courses, etc. So here, this is also important for day-to-day life. In that, letters to school authorities, maybe letter to principal, it will include. Then regarding admissions, some inquiries also we have to do. Then school issues, requirements, so many things are there. Concerned with that, we can draft nice letter, and it will help you in future as well. So whatever we are learning in English, all that things will help you in your daily life. And as a commerce student, this type of drafting skill, speaking skill, communication skill, convincing skill, all that skills are very important, because you are the genuine personality for everyone, that you will have that opportunity, platform to convince others and become leader. So here, third very long answer question, in that composition in the form of article, speech, report, narrative, debate writing, contemporary topical issues to be a part of speech and debate writing, for example, process should be permitted as a democratic right. So here they have given, and it is for the 8 months. So now we will think about this, that they have given long answer question composition, in that article writing, speech writing, report writing, narrative or debate writing. All these skills are also equally important for our day-to-day life. Then grammar, 6 objective type questions. So nature of the question would be objective type. So here different grammatical structures in meaningful context will be tested. Patterns types will be include gap filling, sentence reordering, dialogue completion, and sentence transformation. The grammar syllabus will include determiners, tenses, clauses, modals, and change of voice. These grammar areas will be tested through 6 objective type questions on the following preferably contextualized grammar, in that A, error correction, editing task, close passages, then B, reordering of sentences, transformation of sentences. So now again we will think, so here in writing skill, especially here writing skill and here grammar. So we have discussed the question number first, in that they have given short answer question, and it is for how many marks? 4 marks. So here we will just mark here short answer for 4 marks. Then what is here it is discussed, in that 2 long answer questions. So 6 into 2, that is for 6 into 2 for 12 marks. Then plus one more again, it is given long answer question, in that article, speech, report, like that long answer questions will be asked, and it is for 8 marks. And then grammar, 6 objective type question. So here 6 objective type question means 6 mark. Here total if you will take, here 6 into 2. Now here 12 for 16, and then this 6 plus 8. So total if you will count, it will be of 30 marks. Have you understood? I hope that this short answer, then this is for letter. Usually they are asking for 120 to 150 words. And then this is long composition, and this is for grammar. Then section C, this section it is also asked for 13 marks. Literature means you have purchased 2 books, so question will be asked from that books. Now state board students up till 10th standard, the question paper pattern, in that sim passages they used to give, and you used to practice that. But here sim passages they will not give, They will ask directly question on the lesson. So what type of questions they will ask, that first we will discuss. Questions from the prescribed text to test comprehension at different levels, like literal, inferential, and evaluative questions will be asked. Here, question number one, in that, two objective type questions out of three, and questions will be based on extract from poetry to assess reference to context, comprehension, and appreciation. Direct questions to be avoided. So they will not ask direct questions. Reference to the lines to be made to answer questions based on the given extract. So here, when you will learn any poem, from that poem, one stanza or three, four lines will be given to you, and on that particular stanza, question will be said, and you have to answer that questions. So that question will be based on the understanding level. This is extract based questions. Once you will understand the poem, it will be easy to answer. So no problem in this. So how many questions they will ask? They will ask here three questions in that you have to attempt two. So we have two objective type questions out of three. So this will be for 2 marks. So this 2 marks is for poetry. Then 5 short answer questions out of 6. 3 questions should be from Hornbill. Means we have 2 books. In that, one is Hornbill and one is Snapshot. So 3 questions should be from Hornbill, based on prose, poetry, and plays from both the texts. So here, prose, poetry, plays, all types of, different types of lessons would be there in both the books, and they will ask the questions based on all that. Questions should be elicit in inferential responses through critical thinking. So here, in critical thinking, they will ask you such type of questions that they will not ask direct questions, but understanding of the lesson is very important. On the basis of lesson understanding, you can give that answers properly. So 2 marks, here 5 questions, total 10 marks. Actually, they are asking how many questions? 5 short answer questions out of 6. So they will give you 6 questions. Out of that, you have to write 5 questions. So here we will write. Then, third question, in that, 1 long answer question out of 2 from Hornbill. So they will ask question only from the Hornbill book, and word limits to be answered in 120 to 150 words based on prescribed text to assess global comprehension. Questions to provide evaluative and analytical stimuli to be the learners using incidents, events, themes as reference points. And this will be asked for 6 marks. So now 2 marks here for poetry, then 10 marks for short answer questions. In that, 3 questions are for Hornbill, and remaining questions will be from natural. And now this is for 6 marks. So, question number 4. One long answer question that now we have discussed. Now, question number 5. This one more here, again we will add, that is for 6 mark. It is also from the long answer question. One long answer question out of 2 from snapshot to be answered in 120 to 150 words based on the incidents and events to test global comprehension. Question to elicit creative responses and ability to form opinions. So here 6 mark questions they are asking from both the books. One long answer question out of 2 from snapshot. Here 2 marks from poem. Here from all lessons, means including poem also they can ask. 2 marks question, total question they will ask 6, we have to attempt 5. Here they will give 1 question extra, means 2 questions out of that 1 we have got it. This is from Hornbill. And then next question, 6 mark they will ask from the snapshot. So now next question, question number 5, in that one long answer question out of 2 from Hornbill to be answered in 120 to 150 words. Question to provide evaluative and analytical stimuli to the learners using incidents, events, themes as reference points. So this question, it is from the Hornbill. Now for Hornbill, here in this question, question number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here question number 3 and question number 5. So that both the questions will be from Hornbill. So weightage of the Hornbill is more and the snapshot weightage as compared to the Hornbill, it is less. Because here also in this 10 marks question, total questions they will give 6. From that 3 questions should be from Hornbill. And poems are not there in the snapshot. So these 2 marks it will be from Hornbill. So you have to give more weightage to the Hornbill textbook. Then next, ASL, assessment of listening and speaking. So this is for internal assessment. And in this, 20 marks, it is given for 20 marks. But when we are taking the exam, that time, listening task will be for 20 marks and speaking task will be for 20 marks. We have total 40 marks and then that 40 marks will be divided by 2 and whatever marks you will get that will be for, it will be converted into 20 marks. So listening task will be for 20 marks, speaking task will be for 20 marks and then that average whatever you will get, then it will be converted into 20 marks. So written paper it will be for 80 marks, 20 marks section A, reading comprehension, then section B, Writing skill and grammar. Section C, 30 marks, literature. So your total here it will be of 80 marks. Written paper and then internal assessment 20 marks. Total 100 marks assessment. Total assessment will be 100 marks. Usually we are taking integrated test. Every month one integrated test we are taking. In middle we will take instrument exam and then again integrated test. Like you might have heard that unit test, it is like that. Here integrated test, maybe one unit, two units, three units. So it will be combined and whatever the chapters we will cover in that month, so that syllabus will be asked accordingly. And then final exam. But up till 9th standard, or you might have observed the syllabus pattern, but here 11th standard, whatever portion it will be asked for semester, first semester, again that portion will be asked for the second semester, means second semester will be annual portion, means from first chapter to last chapter, all the topics you have to study. So this is annual syllabus, whatever annual pattern here it is given, and it is for all the subjects. So whenever you are observing, then observe in a sense that all the topics we have to learn in proper way and keep revising the topics for better understanding. So I hope that today's session you will understand the paper design in proper way. Make notes of all the topics whatever now today I have discussed, and if there would be doubt, then you can ask me on group or personally.